Now to the penultimate event on the track. On another atmospheric evening, it's the final of the women's 800 metres, and what a race in prospect. Wang becoming the first athlete from China to appear in this fabulous race. Inside 2 minutes this year. Alex Bell, a late call-up for Laura Muir, choosing to focus on the 15. What a story. This, without doubt, the biggest race of her career. Raevyn Rogers came from nowhere in the World Championship final 2 years ago to take silver. Could the American do so again here in Japan? Habitam Alemu, African Championship bronze 3 years ago. Huge occasion for the proud East African. Gemma Riki, the second of three British women in this race, twice a European indoor under 23 champion. Trains with Laura Muir, she's in the form of her life. Can she deliver under the most intense pressure? Natoya Gul, the Pan American champion, the Commonwealth silver medalist, the third fastest in the world this year. Does history beckon for Jamaica over the half mile? Keely Hodgkinson, European indoor champion, and she's only 19. So composed, so focused. And she's going to have to beat another 19-year-old if it's to be glory. Athing Mu, bidding to become the first American woman to take this Olympic title for more than half a century. The fastest woman in history over the 4 and 800 metres for her age. Here is the lineup. And I think it's the first time in a global 800 metre race that there have been three British athletes featuring since the men's final in Moscow, which was Ko Ovet and David Warren. A lot of expectation and intrigue for Athing Mu. Is she going to go out hard and do it all on her own from the front?
I think she runs the same way she always runs. If that means she's in the front because no one else goes with her, then yes. But I don't think she changes. I think it relies on the other seven runners to see if that makes her a front runner, if that makes sense.
She's certainly capable of taking this out at a very, very fast pace indeed. Rogers, the silver medalist 2 years ago. Alemu, African Championship bronze. Gemma Riki, European indoor glory. Natoya Gul has won the Pan American champs. Keely Hodgkinson, a European champion. Mo, so many records, so many accolades. It's the ultimate race for her. Wang of China, creating history for the Asian nation. And Alexandra Bell, completing the lineup of three Britons in this race. The final of the women's 800 metres is underway. This iconic distance, half a mile, eight specialists. It's one of the most intriguing fields we've ever seen, including two teenagers. And it looks like it's Athing Mu, the American, who's taken it on. And we have the answer to the first intriguing question. She hasn't gone out lightning quick. This is steady.
Steady, and I'm not sure you want to leave it to her over the last 400, because her open 400 is magnificent as well. So she's able to control the race from there. I don't know that anybody can go with her if they run as fast as she does in that first lap. So I think that she certainly has everyone's attention, and they're going to let her dictate, and that's what she's done. And they're going to come through here in what, 57?
They take the bell. In the final of the women's 800 metres, Athing Mu, whose family moved to the United States from South Sudan for a different life, for a better life. does glory beckon for the American? She's put herself out there to be tracked, and it's Athing Mu at the moment coming up onto the shoulder of the Jamaican. And watch for Keely Hodgkinson, the other teenager in this race. She's in fifth place. Gemma Riki trying to find a way through on the inside, the Briton. Remember, the last British woman to win this title was Kelly Holmes in 2004. Athing Mu has the gap on the outside, but she's left a gap on the inside there. Now she begins to hug, and Athing Mu is coming away. She's going to create history for the United States. Their first champion in half a century. A 19-year-old wins it. A 19-year-old takes the silver. Keely Hodgkinson of Great Britain. The two youngsters did dominate in the end. Mo looked effortless. She began to pull the trigger and pull away, and all but Hodgkinson failed to respond. What a moment for a young woman whose family started life in South Sudan. She has been embraced by the American middle distance running community, and she responds with a moment of glory they haven't seen for half a century. And Keely Hodgkinson of Great Britain ran the race of her young life. 155.21, 155.88. Brilliant performances. And Raevyn Rogers came across the line to deny Gemma Riki the bronze by a dip in the last 5 metres. How about that? The two teenagers coming in here with the least amount of experience demonstrated the best tactical spirit and awareness.
Millennials for the medals, and Rogers again with that great finish to pick off a global medal. But Athing Mu, that's the thing with Mo, she never tires. She just strides away from everybody. She does it at the trial. She did it at the conference meets. It doesn't seem to matter the competition. College, the best in the U.S. now, the best in the world. In the last 100 meters, the last 150, she simply runs away from everyone. And they will be excited from New Jersey to College Station, Texas. They are yelling Giga Maggies for Athing Mu.
A national record for Mo with the gold. A national record for Hodgkinson with the silver. Look at those times. Personal bests almost all the way through the field. You have to feel a little bit sorry for Gemma Riki missing out by 900ths of a second. Raevyn Rogers did exactly what she did in Doha 2 years ago, coming from nowhere to finish on the podium. Wow. America 1 and 3, Great Britain 2, and I know there's so much excitement about Mo in the States, yeah. And there's equal hype and hysteria for Keely Hodgkinson. Now, at this stage, Mo left a gap on the inside, and Gemma Riki looked like she was about to try and find it. Gould was going well here at the moment, but went backwards. And this is the moment. Mo then switches to the inside. Riki begins to tie up. Hodgkinson is guaranteed the silver at this point. She's pulling away from Riki. And look how far back Raevyn Rogers is at this stage.
Knows her race, knows what she can do, knew that she couldn't take that pace with Mo, and because she was with her at the trials, kind of had a sense of what that was and was able to read the field and come through. But that is just a magnificent run. And I'm telling you now, they will run her on the 4x4. Almost guaranteed that she will find herself carrying the baton at some point for the U.S. in the 4x4. I'd be stunned if she doesn't.
And why wouldn't you, when she's run 49.57 and broken Sanya Richards-Ross national junior record?
I've never seen anybody like her in the 800. I've yet to see her back up even once. She just strides away. Usually someone, somewhere you've seen these people tie up. Doesn't happen.
A brilliant performance from two teenagers. I had a funny feeling that Hodgkinson would be the one of the Britons to win a medal, because she just has a maturity that belies her tender years. It was a fabulous, fabulous run from Hodgkinson. And you cannot ask any more of a world-class athlete than a personal best in an Olympic final. Both of them delivered a slice of double history.
And she says one of her heroes is Madeline Manning Mims, who of course won the first 800 in 1968 in Mexico City and had such great longevity in that event. Ran well into her 30s as one of the best in the States, multiple times in the games. And if she's able to do that, my goodness.
A fine half-mile race as darkness descended on the stadium at the end of a brilliant session. Sergei Bubka, a busy man in the sunshine. He's certainly earned himself a cold drink after this stint here in his role as the IOC member for Ukraine. And I'm sure he would have been impressed at the composure of the two teenagers who've shared gold and silver in this 800 metres. That's Robin Eugenio, World Athletics Council member for the Federated States of Micronesia. Not a bead of sweat.
Oh, well, look at that jaunty little topper he's got right there.
What a great race it was for the Americans for not one, but two medals. In Doha 2 years ago, Raevyn Rogers came from about seventh to second in the last 50 meters. History repeated itself here in the Olympic Stadium as she snatched bronze from Great Britain's Gemma Reekie with a dip on the line. The World Championship silver medalist is the Olympic bronze medalist. A fine, fine performance.
It's always so fun to watch them as they inspect the medal and feel the weight of it as they put it in their hands.
Keely Hodgkinson could go on to become the greatest 800 meter runner in British women's history. 19 years of age, the European indoor champion becomes the Olympic silver medalist. Such composure and running a national record as well. A performance of absolute class. She looked really strong throughout the race. It was always going to be hard for her to beat the woman who followed her as world indoor record holder over the 800 meters. And the second of our 19-year-olds came here and conquered all. Her family moved from South Sudan to New Jersey in the year 2000. For more than 20 years, they've made their life in the United States. And in Athing Mu, they have raised a daughter to be so immeasurably proud of. The first American woman to win this title since 1968. She went to the front, she pulled away, and she was never to be caught.
And a special, she's 19, a special kid beyond that. Your coach just says there's not a better human being in addition to all that generational talent, which is always great to hear.
And she turns now to proudly hear the United States national anthem.
Now that brief bit where they can take the masks off and get the smiling pictures. I always think we talked about how young they are at 19. Is to get perspective on that, like a year ago, she was moving into her dorm room at university to be a freshman. And you think, what were you doing at 19? Just any of us. You know, certainly there were people that ran in World Junior Championships athletically and do that, but just the average person that watches this to appreciate, what were you at 19? Far from fully formed, obviously, but just, you know, you were trying to get home before curfew, just simple things.